about the ant. I'm not talking about your dad's sister. I'm talking about the insect. You know, the one that you might find in your kitchen from time to time. Every now and then I find a row of ants. You think at first there's just a couple of them walking by, you know, a couple at a time. But then you start to look closer and you see they come from the front door, in the house, and along the baseboard, and past the table on the other baseboard, up the wall and into the cabinet where you find a half-eaten Starburst that your kids had left there before. So you clean out the drawers, and you get out the spray, and you spray it down with the Raid, and you wipe them out, and you get back to normal. So I'm not a huge fan of the ant. But as we look at Proverbs chapter 6 today, we're going to see that the ant is the star of the show, because the ant is a worker, and we can learn a lot from the ant. As we dig into Proverbs, I'd encourage you to join us. For the month of January here at Long Beach CRC, we are journeying through the book of Proverbs as we search out wisdom, as we see God's instruction for our daily lives and how to navigate best. So we read one chapter a day. So here we are on January 6th. We're looking at Proverbs chapter 6. Our Sunday messages and my midweek messages for this month will also be planned to work on Proverbs. So I'd encourage you to join us. Here we are in Proverbs chapter 6. Look at verses 6 through 11 and some bonus verses out of Proverbs chapter 26. It says this, "Go to the ant, you sluggard." So it says, go to the ant. I just take that to mean, you know, consider the ant. And then he gives this word sluggard. You know, I think of sluggish. It's not a word we use a lot with sluggard, but sluggish is something that's slow moving. Someone who is lazy, always looking to take the easy road or shrug off their work onto somebody else. It says, consider its ways, this being the ant, and be wise. So we have a contrast being set up here between the sluggard and the ant. Here's what it says about the ant. It has no commander, no overseer, or ruler. So nobody watching it. Yet, I think that's kind of a key word here, yet, what it does instead is stores its provisions in summer and gathers its food at harvest. You know, one of my old mentors from way, way back, I remember saying this, that the best discipline is self-discipline. So if you don't want someone to watch your work or stand over you or always telling you what to do, then the answer is simple. Then do it on your own. The ant has no one telling you what to do, yet it gets the job done anyway. Then we move forward. It says, how long will you lie there, you sluggard? So there's that word again, sluggish. When will you get up from your sleep, a little slumber, a little folding of the hands to rest, and poverty will come on you like a thief, and scarcity like an armed man. I think this idea of thief and armed man, just suddenly and unexpectedly, you're going to be broke. So here's a few things we learn about this sluggard. I'm going to steal some ideas from John Ortland, whose book I'm reading on Proverbs. He says this, first, the sluggard refuses to make up his mind. He's uncommitted. We talked about this past Sunday, the simple in Proverbs, uncommitted. They can't decide what to do. And so he just lays there. You know, when are you going to get up from your sleep? You know, how long are you going to lie there? A little sleep, a little slumber, just indecisive, not even knowing what to do. So he does nothing. And then we see later in Proverbs some of more the problem with the sluggard. Then the sluggard has some issues of creating these big excuses and making these challenges that don't even really exist. Like this, it says in Proverbs 26, a sluggard says, there's that word, there's a lion in the road, a fierce lion roaming in the streets. So of course, there's no real lion roaming in the streets. He's just making up these fantasies and these ideas and these excuses, these challenges, say it's too hard, I can't do this, I'm not even going to start. And then finally, it says this about the sluggard. It says, as a door turns on its hinges, so a sluggard, there he is again, turns on his bed, just rolling over back and forth. It says the sluggard buries his hand in the dish. He is too lazy to bring it back to his mouth. So he can't even finish the job. He's too lazy to even bring his hand back to his mouth. So we see a contrast here between the sluggard and the ant. Let's be like the ant.
So I'll wrap it up with a quote and a couple thoughts. One of my favorite quotes on work ethic comes from Sam Ewing, a former baseball player, and he says this, hard work spotlights the character of people. Some turn up their sleeves, some turn up their noses, and some don't turn up at all. You know, in the world we live in, work is often kind of a dirty word. You know, people hear the idea of work, let's get to work, and they feel like, ugh, work. But just remember that God created work good. He gave us talents, he gave us opportunities, he gave us skills that we could serve him, that we could serve others well. And I find that when we do this and do it right, we find this great deal of sense of satisfaction. That's what we're called to. So I'd encourage you today to work well in your homes, to work at your jobs, to work for your churches, wherever those may be, that you would turn up your sleeves and get to it. And one last quick thought. You know, we read the Bible a lot, and here in Proverbs we see it again, that God has this gold standard, this ideal for how we are called to live. And I realize that so often I'm not even close, or I'm not matching up to this. You know, his standard is here, and I'm living somewhere in here. And that's why we ask for grace. Grace for pardon, that he would forgive us, and grace for power, that we could live better. So enough listening to me. Let's get up and get to work. You and to make you known.